All right, good evening, everybody. Welcome to Fulton Street Collective. Thank you for joining us. Tonight, we are proud to present the Matthew Muneses Quintet, as we do with all of our performances here, accompanied by a live visual artist. Tonight, our live visual artist is Melanie Brown. Give it up for Melanie. Melanie is in the lower left-hand side of your screen. She'll be painting and sketching the band as they perform, and it's really cool. You probably know this already. You can buy her artwork in the lower right-hand side of the screen. That is the virtual tip jar. That's how we do everything these days. That's how you tip the band. That's how you buy some artwork if you like what you see in here. That is how you support Fulton Street Collective so we can keep doing these performances. All right, we're going to start the show. On drums, we have Dana Hall. On bass, Clark Sommers. On piano tonight, Stu Mindeman. On trumpet, Zubin, Edalji. And on alto saxophone, Matthew Muneses.
Thank you. thank you all for joining us. As Chris mentioned, I am Matthew Muneses. This is my quintet, and am I allowed to do this? Am I allowed to take it off? I feel weird reaching. That first tune was called Alin Manglahi. So all of the music you're gonna hear tonight is all of the music from a project that I'm doing called Noli Me Tangeri, named after kind of a landmark novel in the Philippines written by Jose Rizal, who is generally considered to be the first national hero of the Philippines. And he was a polymath. By trade, he was an ophthalmologist. But as you can tell, he wrote a novel that made a pretty big splash, so he did a lot of things. And I found out when I was researching and learning about my cultural heritage, because as you might assume, I'm Filipino. I probably wouldn't do this project if I wasn't. But as I was learning more about Jose Rizal, yeah, he apparently, through sheer force of will, taught himself how to play music and compose. And this first piece is actually one of his compositions. The title translates roughly to "In Any Race," and the general thrust of all of Rizal's works and advocacy were generally geared towards highlighting the mistreatment of Native Filipinos at that time. We're thinking late. We're talking about mid to late 19th century, 1800s, right around the end of Spanish colonization, and a lot of it was just about how, frankly, crappy it feels to be oppressed by people that are human just like ourselves. And I feel that we all want to be treated the same. We all want to be treated equally, no matter who or what or where we're from. And so this resonated with me a lot, not just as a musician that plays Black American music for a living. I resonate strongly, obviously, with that, with the plights of that community, but we're all in it together, too. And we all have struggles, and as a result, this is the thrust of the project. So, yeah, the next tune we will continue with is called Kundiman ni Rizal. Basically, he wrote kind of a love poem. Kundiman are Filipino, like, love songs, and this one was kind of a love song to his countrymen who he was trying to get amped up enough to fight back against the Spanish. So we continue with Kundiman ni Rizal. Thank you very much.
Thank you. All right. So, we will close the first set. Now, I know it seems like we're maybe trying to close up shop early, but no. We'll take you guys on a journey, hopefully. So this last tune is another of Rizal's compositions called Canto de Maria Clara. The lyrics to this song actually were part of Noli Mi Tangere. In the novel, there's a chapter where a bunch of young ladies and honorable gentlemen, we have to make sure that the reader knows that they are honorable gentlemen, and they're all like kind of rowing along in a river, and they kind of come to a place of rest, and they're having a picnic and lunch and stuff, and they're hanging out, and one of the ladies asks Maria Clara, who is kind of the main love interest of Rizal's stand-in character for himself named Cristosimo Ibarra. And they're like, come on, you have the prettiest voice, please sing. They give her a harp, and she sings this, frankly, pretty depressing song about how to die without feeling like you have a place in your country is not a fun feeling. So, with that, we're gonna try to bring the joy and play Canto de Maria Clara. Thank you again. Thank you.
All right, let's give it for Matt Muneses Quintet. That's Dana Hall on drums. Clark Sommers on bass. Stu Mindeman on piano. Zubin Edalji on trumpet. And on alto saxophone and compositions, Matthew Muneses. Yeah, got that. Easy for me to say. All right, that is the end of set number one. We have yet another set for you, so please stick around. If you look behind me, there's a lot of green behind me. That is the thematic color of the next 15 minutes. Green. Please be kind, please be generous, please be supportive. Show some green, show some support. Tip the band, buy some artwork. If you like what you see in here, you can donate to Fulton Street Collective so we can keep doing these performances. We're gonna take a short break. See you in about 15 minutes. Stick around. All right, we're back. Welcome to set number two with Matt Muneses Quintet. Give a warm welcome back to the stage. Playing the drums tonight is Dana Hall. On bass, Clark Sommers. On piano this evening is Stu Mindeman. Switching it up a bit tonight, bringing Jon Irabagon in on tenor saxophone. And on alto saxophone and compositions, Matthew Muneses.
Yeah. Sorry to everybody for making all the pronunciation stuff confusing. There's the Americanized way of saying it, and then there's the Filipino way of saying it. I'm not going to talk too much during this set because it's going to kind of speak for itself. So I'll preface this by saying this whole set is a suite that I wrote called Noli Me Tangeri, after the novel. If you guys remember the first set, some of you might just be tuning in. So there's a novel. Jose Rizal wrote it. And the suite encompasses kind of the narrative arc of the novel, following some loose threads of some of the characters. But also there are themes in the book. For example, the second movement is called Cruelty and Injustice. I'll just tell you the titles now. The first movement is called A Son Returns, because at the beginning of the novel, again, Rizal's stand-in character, Ibarra, comes back from having studied in Spain, which is actually what Rizal did in real life. And in the book, his character returns to find that his father was unjustly imprisoned and then died in prison and then was denied a proper Christian burial, which in the 1800s was like a huge slight, and still is now to some people, but big slight in the 1800s. So this first movement kind of encompasses the bittersweet idea of coming home and finding out something terrible happened. Second movement is called Cruelty and Injustice. There are two brothers in the book, very young kids, like 8 and 10, roughly, and they are altar boys for the friars and for what Rizal felt was a pretty corrupt religious order, largely ruled by the Spanish government, or in league with the Spanish government. And so that's when I bring in the other saxophone, and we kind of represent the cruelty inflicted upon the two brothers. Like, one of the friars kills one of the younger brother because they, like, quote unquote, stole money, even though they definitely didn't, at least from the narrator's perspective. And, so kind of these themes of the pain of being mistreated by people that you're taught that you should be trusting. And the third movement kind of continues that. Education for All is the name of the third movement. Again, highlighting the idea in the book, Rizal wants to open a school to help continue educating the younger, poorer kids that don't have access. And again, in America, in 2021, there's a huge problem with accessibility of education for a lot of people. So, come on, let's get it together. And the last movement, Revolution and Liberation. Disclaimer, I'm not calling for anything violent. I'm not, nothing violent. But we need some type of movement to come up to bring these issues to light. There is work in progress, but we gotta keep it going. The last movement's called Revolution and Liberation, because we all should be free to be who we are and be treated properly. So with that, Noli Me Tangeri. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. One, two, one, two, and...
thank you again for tuning in. We are the Matthew Muneses Quintet Sextet-ish. Jon Irabagon on the tenor saxophone. In the first set, Zubin, Edalji on trumpet. On drums and cymbals, Mr. Dana Hall. On bass, Mr. Clark Sommers. And on piano, Mr. Stu Mindeman. I'm Matthew Muneses. Thank you again for tuning in. Thank you for your generosity. I hope you like the music and wish us luck. We're going into studio tomorrow, man. It's gonna be a long day. So thank you very much.
It is Matthew Muneses Quintet. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. Let's give it up for the band. That's Dana Hall on drums. Yeah. Mark Sommers on bass. Stu Mindeman on piano. Jon Irabagon on tenor saxophone. Paints, brushes, canvas, Melanie Brown. All right, that's it for tonight. We are back here tomorrow night with the John Rarick, Josh Torrey Quintet for Jazz Record Art Collective. The band will be performing Clark Terry and Bob Brookmeyer's 1965 release, Power of Positive Swinging. So please come back for that. It is time to be generous and kind. Think green. Please tip the band. Please be generous. Please be kind. Buy some artwork. If you like what you see in here, you can donate to Fulton Street Collective, so we can keep doing these performances. If you don't have any bread, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel. Totally free, prices so low, they are?
Insane,
that's exactly right. This is very much a collaborative effort. Let's give it up for Kenny Claymore on sound. And the man who makes the band look good, he works hard while they play, Jose Valle. We're back here tomorrow night. Until then, keep your masks on.